Okay, Jed. So let's discuss. Yeah. Let's address the elephant in the room, because you were supposed to join. You were supposed to join us in the studios weeks ago, but you couldn't because ABC has a very strict policy. You can't get into this building unless you're fully vaccinated. Everybody in this room knows that and is vaccinated. But you made a conscious decision not to get the vaccine. Now the CDC says a person is 10 times less likely to be hospitalized from COVID and 11 times less likely to die if they've gotten the vaccine. Okay, so why didn't you get it?
Yeah, so my story is a little bit unique. I'll share that first before I get into those CDC numbers. But
remember, we have only a certain amount of time, Jed, if you want to get everything in.
I have. Right. So I want to let people know why I'm not there. I have a medical exemption to the vaccine that's been written by my infectious disease vaccinated specialist in New York City that's been co-signed by three other doctors. I'm not a candidate for this vaccine. I also have sky-high, multi-tiered, multifaceted natural immunity, very, very high, that has also been proven. It has been shown, and it is substantiated by letters from these doctors. So for me personally, this vaccine poses a greater risk than a benefit. I'm also not a risk to any of you. I know there's been a lot of debate about that, but I have these doctors who've gone on record with that as well. So my point about all of this is that I am not anti-vax. What I really want is for people to make these decisions for themselves. I want every one of you to sit with your family members, to sit with your trusted doctors, and to say, what is the best decision for me? However, I do oppose mandates. I oppose them on the fact that, let's look at the science. This is a vaccine that was created to prevent severity of disease and to prevent hospitalizations. Now, we can have a whole debate on that in itself, but the vaccine does not prevent you from getting COVID and does not prevent you from transmitting COVID.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, no,
and we have that's seen that. Not so. Come on.
No,
you've been at Fox TV too long.
You don't have to listen to me on that. You don't have to listen to me. You can listen to the director of the CDC. You can look at the CDC's website. That is why masks were reinstated for people who were vaccinated, because they said, and they admitted, they came out and said, this Delta variant, transmission is going to be a thing for vaccinated and unvaccinated people. So I'm not opposed to the vaccine, I am opposed to the mandate 100% on the grounds of science.
762,000 people have died from COVID, including Manny's in-laws. And we've been friends a long time, but Manny's parents, I just don't understand why you would choose to prioritize your personal freedom over health and safety of others. And
so
don't think that we should allow this kind of misinformation on our website. We've had the United States Surgeon General debunk.
Yes, I heard what he said.
Everything that you've just said, and I just don't think we should allow this kind of misinformation
on
our air. I'm really sorry, Sunny, my friend.
I would say to you as a friend, what I just said to you is I am prioritizing my health, and people talk about the common
over
good.
Over the health and safety
of other
people.
You're not going to have a common good if you're not prioritizing your own health. You have
over
a Surgeon
the health
General.
And
this should, sound,
the
very,
so,
this should sound very familiar to you, Jed. This should sound very familiar to you. We got to go to break. And so I have to say, thanks to Jed
Diabila,
you can buy
science.
Jed's book, Dear Hartley, starting today. And everyone in the audience, you're each going home with a copy of it.